Hello guys, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to be doing a quick update on Bitcoin. So what I have here is the Bitcoin versus US dollar 1 day candles from Bitfinex. I have just watched a video from the channel, what was it? World Crypto Network, and ToneBase was making a quick review on the Bitcoin price, and he was, as usual, using the what he calls the numerical indicator. Before I start, I want to clarify that I respect ToneBase a lot. I think he's the only one on YouTube that has the highest record of getting it right. So I have followed ToneBase for very long time, and I like how he analyzes. But at the same time, I think he's too he lets his political views get in the middle of the way many times. Anything that is not Bitcoin is a scam. He made a call for Ethereum that was very wrong, and it's all because of his political views. So I think in general he's too bullish on Bitcoin and too bearish in any other thing because of his political views. So that gets in the middle of his analysis. But with this being said, I still think he's a good analyst. So this video is not to, not to say he's a bad analyst or anything like that. So anyways, what I heard now in his video, he said that we hit number 9 on the daily chart. You can see this is number 9, and it's a bullish 9. So you, according to this indicator, you could enter a bullish position here, because now we should start getting a count from 1 to 9 and the upside. So we should be going up. Well, that is not true according to the theory behind this indicator. For a 9 to be valid, the lowest of the 9 should be lower than the 8, the 7, and the 6. So if the number 9 is not lower, the lowest of the 9 is not lower than the 8, 7, and 6, according to this theory, you will continue to get nines until you actually get to a lower point than the 8, 7, or 6. So the lowest point was 3,000, more or less, 2,985 on Bitfinex. Anyways, it's going to be a little bit different from exchange to exchange. But for a 9 to be valid, we should be getting 3,000 or lower. Otherwise, according to this theory, we will continue to get nines on the downside. The developer, I don't want to get any business from ToneBase. I mean, this is not called numerical indicator. I don't care. I'm not going to say the name or anything, but I'm a big fan of the developer of this indicator. I made a tutorial about 1 week ago in another, it was about another theory from the same developer of this indicator. And anyways, I know the theory very well, and this is not a valid 9. I just wanted to clarify this. My last video on Bitcoin was yesterday. I didn't make a video, but the day before I made my speculation for Bitcoin. It'd be that it's gonna go to somewhere around 4,000 and then crash again. I'm still holding on this theory. Bitcoin doesn't look bullish at the moment. It doesn't look very, very bearish. There's a lot of mixed signals, but I still think we can go to somewhere in 4,000 and then crash back down, because we have to break many resistances now to, to actually go up to all-time highs again, to the 5,000. We're below moving average here. The weekly looks very, very bearish. If we look at the weekly, looking at this indicator alone, we have only a number 1 here going down. The RSI just crossed, so when the lines cross here, the RSI, the blue below the red, that's a sell signal. So you should be selling there according to the RSI. Of course, you don't look only to one single indicator, but if we see the RSI, not only it just crossed and it's trending down, but the divergence. So the divergence, probably most of you already know this, but if you don't know, that's a strong sign. When the price is uptrending, the current high is higher than the than the previous high. So we have a higher high here, a lot higher actually, from 3,000 to 5,000. This is uptrending, but the RSI shows downtrending. So the previous high on the RSI is here and the current high is all the way down here. It means if the price is going up, but the RSI is going down, it means prices have to go down, you know, to stabilize, to balance out with the RSI. So we should be going down according to the RSI, not only trending down, but the divergence. It's very exaggerated how the price is uptrending and the RSI is downtrending. Huge red volume as well, so it's not looking bullish, to be honest. Now, do the indicators work always 100%? No, of course not. Anything could happen and anything is possible. There's no indicator that is 100% reliable, although the numerical, I'm going to call it numerical indicator, that's not the name, but according to this indicator, we should be going down. And what I was going to say is this indicator is actually quite reliable. It's very reliable. When you use this indicator, you should not be looking at any other indicators. You should be looking only at this one alone, which is the opposite with classic trading. In classic trading, you always should be looking at least three indicators pointing to the same thing. But when you use this indicator, you should be looking only at this indicator alone. The theory says you don't look at any other indicator, only this numerical indicator, just like other indicators developed by the same person. With this numerical indicator, his indicators should be used alone. His techniques should be used alone without looking at any other indicator. So yeah, I remain neutral, leaning to bearish for Bitcoin. I think it's possible we go somewhere near 4,000 and then we would be going down again. We could even break 4,000. We have another downtrend resistance above this one. So that would be like, what, between 4,100 and 4,200, and then we would be going down according to the patterns. Now I'm going to repeat this again. I think I said it in the last two videos. After we broke the $3,000 mark, we broke out all the way to 5,000. This doesn't look as top of the bubble as it looked down here when we were at 3,000 and we started having this started having these crashes and up and down, and we could not break the all-time highs at 3,000. Like after three or four tries we couldn't break it. That was just like how tops look. That's how tops work. So that was a perfect top. Now after we broke this one, this created here like a consolidation before we broke up again. So now this top at 5,000 doesn't look like the very top. It doesn't look as much as a market top as this one here at 3,000. Just because we broke the 3,000, you know, now this could be a standard consolidation. If this is a standard consolidation, then we should be going higher than that, you know. But yeah, so that's my reasoning as for why this doesn't look as much as a market top as the 3,000 top did. So we could be getting some consolidation here, some more crash up and down, and then we could be breaking the 5,000 and going maybe those. My call is 6,000. Because usually the second wave, usually if we go in waves of three, we usually have three waves. If after three waves we make higher highs, then we will have five waves. If after five waves we break higher highs, then it's seven waves. So, and if that one breaks up and we continue to go up, then you add two more waves, and you keep adding two more waves every time. But the typical is three waves. So if this is one wave and now we had a second wave, we need another wave. But according to the Elliott Waves theory, the second wave is usually the longest one. So we had here one that it's not as long, retracement. And then we had, if this is the second wave, which should be because it's longer than the previous one, now we should have another one, but not as long as the second one that we just had. So that's why my call would be 6,000 if we actually break the all-time highs. and we start going up. But it could also perfectly be the very top, and from here go down to somewhere in the 1,000, 1,200. So nothing is very clear with Bitcoin, but that's all I can read for right now. I will keep updating. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.